Hello everyone, this is Sai Sri and welcome to my channel. In this video, let us solve Maths 2A Exercise 2A De Moivre's theorem. So in this first Roman and the second Roman. First Roman, second one we have the important one, that is AP 18 and TS 20. And in second Roman, first one which is repeated in AP 17 and 19 and for TS and 16. And the second question is in TS 18. And fourth question is in TS 19. If you have less time, then be prepared with these problems, the important problems which I had said now. So these are important in this. So let us solve the problems. The basic knowledge to solve this exercise 2A is, first of all, from De Moivre's theorem we have cos theta plus I sin theta whole power n is equal to cos n theta plus I sin n theta. Simply we have to write n theta here and here. If it is minus, that is cos theta minus I sin theta, same formula, but we have to write minus. That is equal to cos n theta minus I sin n theta. So this is the formula. Cos theta plus I sin theta can be said as sis theta. So whole power n. This is sis n theta. And if x equal to cos theta plus I sin theta, then 1 by x, that is reciprocal. Then reciprocal will be cos theta minus I sin theta. And here we have to know modulus amplitude, which we have learnt in complex numbers. That is z is equal to x plus iy. Z is equal to x plus iy. Then mod z. Mod z is equal to r. Then r value is square root of x square plus y square. The first one is, if n is an integer, then show that 1 plus I power 2n 1 minus I power 2n is equal to 2 power n plus 1 cos n pi by 2. So first of all we have to find the mod z. Mod z means x square plus y square. If x plus iy is an expression, then mod z is equal to square root of x square plus y square. So here x equal to 1 and the y equal to 1. So that is equal to root 2. Now mod amplitude form of 1 plus I. Here we have 1 plus I and 1 minus I. First of all, find for 1 plus I. Similarly, we have to find for 1 minus I value also. So 1 plus I. Divide and multiply. So we got R value is root 2. That is mod z. So multiply and divide with the same number. Here we have I. 1 plus I. So write 1 plus I. And we have to divide with root 2. Here also 1 by root 2. Now 1 by root 2 is equal to cos pi by 4. And sine also pi by 4. Write down the expression in cos and sine. So now here we have power 2n. 1 plus I into 2 power n. So that is root 2. So this is the value of 1 plus I which we got earlier. So power 2n. So from De Moivre's theorem, apply 2n. Here apply 2n. Then 2n pi by 4 plus I sine 2n pi by 4. Here 2. Root 2 can be written as 1 by 2. So 1 by 2 into 2n. 2 to get cancelled, that is equal to 2 power n. Into cos 2n pi by 4 plus I sin 2n pi by 4. Now let it be equation 1. Again we have to find 1 minus I to power n. So that is simply we have to put minus here. So this is equation number 2. So in the question they asked to find 1 plus I 2n plus 1 minus I 2n. So this is they asked in the question to prove it as 2n plus 1 cos n pi by 2. Now here we have to do the first and second equations are to be added. Now add them. So add the equations. So in the two equations, here also we have 2 power n. So take 2 power n common. So here I sin n pi by 2 minus I sin n by 2 cancel. Here to have 2 cos n pi by 2s. So 2 cos n pi by 2. Here the bases are equal. So the powers are to be added. So add the powers. N plus 1. So that is cos n pi by 2, which is equal to RHS. So LHS is equal to RHS. And in second Roman first one, here also we have to find the mod z. That is modulus amplitude. Then we will get the R value. That is 2. So we got R value. And here we have 1 plus I root 3. First of all, we have to find the value of this and then we have to apply 3. So, I write down R into. Now, I got 2. So, I have to divide and multiply with the same number. 2, 1 by 2. Plus, here we have to write I. Because complex. So, that is here we already have root 3. So, root 3 again we have to divide. So, this is. So, root 2 is equal to cos pi by 3. Means 60. So, it is equal to cos 60. That can be written as cos pi by 3. And root 3 by 2. Root 3 by 2 is equal to sin 60. So, that is 2 into cos pi by 3 plus I sin pi by 3. Now, what we have to do? Cube. Now, we have to apply cube. So, from De Moivre's theorem, we have to apply. Here, 2 cube and this is in cos theta plus I sin theta power n. It is in this form. So, that is equal to cos n theta plus I sin n theta. Apply now. So, that is 3 pi by 3 plus I sin 3 pi by 3. 3 get cancelled. So, that is 8 into cos pi plus I sin pi. Cos pi value is minus 1 and sin pi value is 0. So, that is equal to 8 into minus 1, that is minus 8. This is important problem for examination point of view. Important one. So, z is equal to, first of all, you have to find the 1 plus I value, then we have to apply power 8. First, we have to find mod z, that is r equal to root 2. Root 2. Now, what we have to do? Multiply and divide with the same number. 2, 1 by root 2. Here we have minus. So, minus, here we have I by, and we have to multiply and divide. So, here we have multiplied. So, here we have to do division. Root 2. 1 by root 2 is equal to pi by 4. That is 45 degrees. Cos 45 degrees value is 1 by root 2. Minus sin pi by 4. 1 by root 2. We have to write here. So, every time we have to convert into cos and sin. Now, apply 8. Power 8. Root 2 8 cos pi by 4 minus I sin pi by 4. Root 2 8. So, root 2 means 1 by 2 power 8. Here we have to apply the De Moivre's theorem. That is cos theta plus I sin theta power n equal to cos n theta plus I sin n theta. This is De Moivre's theorem. So, De Moivre's theorem we have to apply 8 pi by 4 minus I sin 8 pi by 4. Now, in 4 table, it is 2 times. So, 2 pi minus I sin 2 pi. 2 pi value, 360. Cos 360 value is 1. And sin 360 value is 0. So, that is equal to 16. So, do the third problem as usually. First of all, we have to find the z value and 1 plus I. So, z value is root 2. Here, we have to multiply and divide with the same number with the given 1. So, 1 by root 2 plus I sin I by root 2 and then convert as cos and sin and apply root 16 and then solve by using the De Moivre's theorem. We will get the 256. Cos 4 pi value is 1 and sin 4 pi value is 0. And the fourth one also in the same model, but here we have 2. So first of all write them. Root 3 by 2 can be written as cos pi by 6. That is cos 30. Cos 30 value is root 3 by 2. And 1 by 2. Sin pi by 6. This is also cos pi by 6 minus I sin pi by 6. Whole power 5. Whole power 5. From De Moivre's theorem we have to write cos 5 pi by 4 6 plus I sin 5 pi by 6 minus cos 5 pi by 6 minus I sin 5 pi by 6. From De Moivre's theorem. The fourth one is also of the same model. Here we have to apply De Moivre's theorem. Just write down the given values into cos and sin values. So, root 3 by 2 is equal to cos 30. So, cos 30 means cos pi by 6 plus I sin pi by 6 minus cos pi by 6 minus I sin pi by 6. Since cos pi by 6 is equal to root 3 by 2, sin pi by 6 is equal to 1 by 2 and apply De Moivre's theorem, that is cos theta plus I sin theta root power n is equal to cos n theta plus I sin n theta. So n, here n is 5. So 5 pi by 6 plus I sin 5 pi by 6. Cos 5 pi by 6 minus I sin 5 pi by 6. Now here minus, minus into minus plus. Here these two will cancel, minus and plus. So here we have 2 I sin 5 pi by 6 is equal to 2 I sin. This 5 by 6 can be written as pi minus pi by 6. See, pi minus pi by 6. Taking 6 as LCM, 6 pi minus pi, that is equal to 5 pi by 6. So again we are getting 5 pi by 6. So write down pi minus pi by 6. So 180 minus x, that is equal to 180 minus theta is equal to theta. It is in second coordinate. So that is pi by 6. 2i psi pi by 6. So pi by 6 means 30. Sin 30 value is 1 by 2. So 2 get cancelled. So the answer is I. So second Roman first one is very very important for examination point of view. If alpha and beta are the roots of the equation x square minus 2x plus 4 is equal to 0. So alpha and beta roots of this equation. For any n belongs to natural numbers n. Show that. So here we have to prove this one. So first of all, find the roots of this equation. This is a quadratic equation. We cannot simplify with factorization method. So I will go with the formula minus b plus or minus b square minus 4ac by 2a. So this is the formula. In this, here we have a is equal to 1, b is equal to minus 2, c is equal to 4. Substitute them. So after substituting the values in this formula, that is minus b plus or minus root over b square minus 4ac by 2a, then we got two roots, that is 1 plus I by root 3 and also 1 minus I root 3. Here now we find the mod amplitude. So here we got one complex root, so that is 2 we have 1 plus I root 3 and another one is 1 minus I root 3. So for this, first of all I am taking 1 plus I root 3. So in this r is equal to root 2, root 4, that is equal to 2. And also theta formula tan inverse y by x. So that is pi by 3. So how we have to write? R into cos theta plus I sin theta. So in place of r we have to substitute 2. And place of theta we have to substitute pi by 3. After finding mod amplitude of this. And then we have to do for 1 plus I root 3 whole power n. Here we have to apply power. Supply power on both sides. So 2 power n is equal to cos pi by 3 plus I sin pi by 3. So from De Moivre's theorem, cos n pi by 3 plus I sin n pi by 3. So let it be equation number 1. Again similarly we have to find 1 minus, because we got 2 roots. One is with plus and another one with minus. So we got another root. Now add 1 and 2. Because they asked to prove this one. Alpha n plus beta n is equal to 2 n plus 1. Cos n pi by 3. This is the thing which we have to prove. So I am doing x power n, alpha power n plus beta power n. So this is alpha power n formula. This is beta power n. Because this is one root, this is one root. Simply we have to apply power n. And then solve it. So we got, applying De Moivre's theorem, we got these two values. So when we add, here 2 power n is common. Take 2 power n common in these two. So here we have these. So minus and plus will cancel. So here we have 2 cos n pi by 3. 2 cos n pi by 3. That is here bases are equal. So powers to be added. N plus 1 cos n pi by 3. So this is the formula. So LHS equal to RHS. And second question is also important, which is repeated for TS 18 and TS 19, if cos alpha plus cos beta plus cos gamma is equal to 0, and which is also equal to sin alpha plus sin beta plus sin gamma. So these two are equal to 0. Then in this bit we have 3 which we can solve very easily. So given cos alpha plus cos beta plus cos gamma is equal to 0. So first of all write the given one. So from this
a.
A term is cos, let it be a is equal to cos alpha plus I sin alpha, and b is equal to cos beta plus I sin beta, and c is equal to cos gamma plus I sin gamma. So cos sin here we have, so cis alpha, here cis beta, here cis gamma. Now add a, b and c. So after adding, here we have cos alpha plus I sin alpha, cos beta plus I sin beta, which is equal to b, this is equal to a, and this is equal to c. In these three, take cos alpha, cos beta, cos gamma common. Take aside, not common, take aside, and here I is common. In these three terms, I is common, so I into sin alpha plus sin beta plus sin gamma. So in the question also they given cos alpha plus cos beta plus cos gamma is equal to 0, and sin alpha plus sin beta plus sin gamma is equal to 0. So substitute 0. So that is equal to 0. So a plus b plus c is equal to 0. Now cubing. When we do cubing, a plus b plus c, c whole cube, that is equal to 0. When we expand this, that is a cube plus b cube plus c cube minus 3abc equal to 0. Send 3abc this side. So here we have to do this one. This is the main step involved in solving this problem. Now a cube means cis alpha cube plus cis beta cube plus cis gamma cube, which we got earlier. So cis alpha, cis beta, cis gamma. So we have to apply cube. And 3 cis alpha, cis beta, cis gamma. So from De Moivre's theorem, cis 3 alpha, cis 3 beta, cis 3 gamma is equal to 3 cis alpha beta gamma. And now here cis 3 alpha can be written as cos 3 alpha plus I sin 3 alpha. This is from De Moivre's theorem. Here also we have to apply the same things. Cos a plus beta plus alpha plus beta plus gamma, alpha plus beta plus gamma. And now here we have I values and the real and imaginary parts. So take the real parts aside and imaginary part aside in this form. So take the real part this side plus I, that is imaginary part. Now equate real part and the imaginary part. So when we equate the real part and the imaginary part, so that is cos 3 alpha plus cos 3 beta plus cos 3 gamma. This is real part. So that is equal to 3 cos alpha plus beta plus gamma. So this is real part. These two are equal. And these two are equal. These two are imaginary parts. So when we equate, then we get first one and second one which they asked to prove. So this is the first one which they asked to prove. And this is the second one. Now the third one we have to do the reciprocals, 1 by a plus 1 by b plus 1 by c, 1 by cis alpha plus 1 by cis beta plus 1 by cis gamma. So inverse means we have to put minus. So minus. Now take real parts and imaginary parts aside. So we already know that a plus b plus c is equal to 0. So here also in question also they gave cos alpha plus cos beta plus cos gamma equal to 0, and sin alpha plus sin beta plus sin gamma is equal to 0. They have given in the question. So substitute the values. 0 minus I into 0 is equal to 0. Now here we have 1 by a plus 1 by b plus 1 by c. Take abc LCM. So that is equal to bc plus ca plus ab. So that means ABC, send this side, that is equal to 0. So this is also equal to 0. Again we have to do it. So that we will get this one. Cis alpha. A is cis alpha. B is cis beta. B is cis beta. C is cis gamma. Cis alpha. B is equal to cis beta. C equal to cis gamma. So cis alpha plus beta plus cis beta plus gamma plus cis gamma plus alpha is equal to 0. Cos alpha plus beta. So this can be written as cis and sin. So separating the real and imaginary parts, cis alpha plus beta plus sin alpha plus beta. cos beta plus gamma plus sin beta plus gamma. So write down. Now equate real part and imaginary part. So when we equate the real part, then we will get the which they asked to prove the third one. So the third one, if n is an integer, then z is equal to sis theta. Sis theta means cos theta plus I sin theta. So z is equal to cos theta plus I sin theta. And then show that z power 2n minus 1 by z power 2n plus 1 is equal to I tan n theta. First of all, let z is equal to sis theta. Sis theta means cos theta plus I sin theta. They given that, first of all, take the LHS value to prove RHS. So LHS is z power 2n minus 1. So z is cos theta plus I sin theta power 2n. So power 2n minus 1. And in the denominator plus 1. So here apply de Moivre's theorem. So that is equal to cos theta plus I sin theta power n, which is equal to cos n theta plus I sin n theta. So this is de Moivre's theorem. So from de Moivre's theorem, 2n. Here we have 2n. So 2n theta plus I sin 2n theta minus 1. Here also the same thing. Now take minus common in these two terms. So taking minus common. So here 1 will be remained. So 1 minus cos n theta plus I sin 2n theta. And in the denominator, take 1 and cos 2n theta aside. 1 plus cos 2n theta plus I sin 2n theta. Here 1 we have written before. So that is here 1 minus cos 2n theta. We know that 1 minus cos 2 theta is equal to 2 sin square theta. So same formula we have to apply here from trigonometry. So that is equal to 1 minus cos 2n theta is equal to 2 sin square n theta. And 1 plus cos 2n theta. 1 plus cos 2 theta is equal to 2 cos square theta. So same formula we have to apply here. But we have n. So simply write n and cos square n theta. Plus sin 2 theta. What we know? Sin 2 theta is equal to, from trigonometry, 2 sin theta cos theta. So this is the sin 2 theta formula from trigonometry. So here we have sin 2 theta, 2n theta. So let it be 2n. So that is equal to 2 sin n theta cos n theta. And here also I sin 2n theta. Apply the same formula here also. Now, here we have minus. So minus means we know I square is equal to minus 1. So in place of minus, I am writing the I square. So I square. 2i square sin square n theta plus I into 2 sin n theta cos n theta. And in the denominator, 2 cos n theta plus I sin I 2 sin n theta cos n theta. Now in these two terms, 2i sin theta is common. Here we have 2i sin theta. Here also we have 2i sin theta. So take 2i sin theta common. So what will be remained here? Here we already taken I. 1i and 1 2. So 1i will be remained here. Here we have I square. So 1i is taken common. So here we have 1i. I. Here we have square. So sin theta, sin n theta. And here cos theta is remained. So write down cos n theta. Divided by, in these two terms also, cos n theta. 2 cos n theta is common. Here we have 2. Here we have 2. So 2. And also cos n theta. Here also we have 2 cos n theta. So take 2 cos n theta common. So what will be remained? So here 1 cos theta is remained. So cos theta. And here 1 I sin theta is remained. So that is cos n theta plus I sin n theta. So here these two terms are same. So these two will cancel. So 2i sin theta, 2 cos theta. 2, 2 also get cancelled. So sin theta by cos theta is tan theta. Here we have one more I. So I tan theta. So that is equal to RHS. So LHS equal to RHS. So fourth problem, here we have to know I square value is equal to minus 1. So they given that 1 plus x power n is this one and asked to prove 2. So in this we have to find, we have to equate the real parts and the imaginary parts to get first one and the second one. First of all, let the x equal to I. So then we can solve. So let it be x equal to I. So if x equal to I, then our expression will change. See, 1 plus I power n is equal to I naught plus I1 I. In place of x, we are writing I. And in place of x square, I square. So in the same way, up to an I power n. So in place of x, we are writing I. So if you find modulus amplitude of 1 plus I, that is equal to root 2. Because x square plus y square. Here x equal to 1, y equal to 1. So 1 square plus 1 square, root 2. So root 2 divide and multiply with the same number. Here we have I, so we are writing I here. So 1 by 2 is equal to pi by 4. And 1 by 2 in sine also pi by 4. So here we have power n. So power n. And now I square value is minus 1. So I square value is minus 1. So in place of I square, we are writing minus 1. So here we have I square. So in place of I square, we write I. That is A2 into minus 1. So that is minus A2. Minus A3. So I cube means I square power 1. I power 1. So I square value is minus 1. Minus 1 into I. So that is minus A3I plus A4 into 1. So on. It will be continued up to I to the power of n times. Now root 2 cos pi by 4. So here the real parts are cos n by 2 cos n pi by 4 is the real part. And 2n by 2 I sine n pi by 4 is imaginary part. So in this, this is real part, this is imaginary part because we have I here. So equate them. If we equate real part, that is 2n by 2 cos n pi by 4 is equal to these terms. So this is the option one which we have to prove. And if we equate the second one, the imaginary parts, so this one is the imaginary part and this one. So then that is equal to option two which we have to prove.